Rio de Janeiro, Ipanema to be precise. And you could be worse places on Earth, I can tell you.
Another day at the office, another day in paradise.
I'm here to around drinking caipirinhas and shoving food in my face mostly. My wife, she's got other business in Rio. But for now, that's her problem.
I'd like to say I feel guilty being out here on this wonderful beach when my wife is falling around on the floor. But I don't really feel bad about that.
Now, as a fresh arrival to these stunning vistas, what do you really need to know?
If you ever want to feel really bad about your body, come to Brazil. You know, everybody looks like they're either on their way to have sex or they've just come from having sex. I tell you, I'm so glad I don't have my shirt off. I really can't suck my gut in for this long. Ooh, look at that fat guy hit that water. I feel better about myself already.
My only problem is the growing understanding that I shall never frolic on this beach in what is deemed appropriate attire. I will not play volleyball with my feet. I will never be, could never have been, a carioca, a resident of Rio, like, say, this guy. Meet Alan, embodiment of the carioca lifestyle.
The beach is considered our living room. It's different from the rest of Brazil. When you invite the other to your home, oh, come to my place. Here we go, you say, ah, we meet in the beach. And we don't have to speak where we go in the beach. Because usually your group always came in the same
place. So your friends know where to find you.
Yeah.
Always the same place.
That's it. It's too carioca.
And while it's never a good idea to overgeneralize, nobody here seems to have a job. They're all far too good-looking and fit to have to work. It seems, anyway. And only a gringo would ask, what do you do for a living?
During the week, what do you do?
I do. I'm a lawyer, but I work for real estate.
You're a lawyer?
Yeah.
I'm in the wrong profession. You're a lawyer. I mean, not everybody on this beach has a great job, right? I mean, this is what's fantastic about Rio, is that you can be successful and wealthy, and you come to the beach. If you're poor, you can also come to the beach. It's a good life, right?
Come to the beach.
That's too late for me. Here's what you got to know. Really, this beach is about getting hammered on caipirinhas, looking at women you're never going to sleep with, and getting a serious sandwich. All right, let's go.
Run, don't walk, to the only place for sandwiches on this beach. So good, they are burned into my brain.
Oh, Barraca de Uruguay, the blue and white flag. It's the mark of quality. And I remember, vividly, the deliciousness of their glistening meats. Sandwich, caipirinha.
What I'm drinking, of course, is the classic caipirinha. Pretty much my constant companion every time I come to Rio. Cachaça, which is basically distilled sugarcane liquor, fresh lime juice, and sugar. The sandwich, grilled pork, slathered with chimichurri, garlic, parsley, oregano, moistened with olive oil, and maybe a touch of vinegar.
Pork, caipirinha, beach. Life is good. Well, I think we've learned something today. You can't be happy eating a moist roast pork sandwich, drinking the caipirinha, with this view in the background and a sea of oily, tight buttocks, you've really got a problem. Or you're a Republican.
The locals usually hang pretty late at the beach, but across the bay in the